It's the Daily Dog.
Hey, y'all, welcome back to the Daily Dog. Thanks for being with me today. Y'all, we are going back to music by Devin Townsend today, and it has been a while since we have listened to music by Devin. I can't believe it has been since the very first week of January of 2022. We listened to his songs Funeral and Bastard and The Death of Music. And now we are going back to that same concert at Royal Albert Hall in 2015 to hear his live rendition of his song called Deadhead. And I am glad that you are here. I'm glad to get back to some music from Devin. Deadhead is from his album called Accelerated Evolution. It was his sixth album, released back in 2003. So on this recording, Devin is the lead vocalist, he's the guitarist, he's the songwriter, he's the producer, and the album is released on his independent label, Heavy Devi Records. So we get a true artist saying what he truly wants to say in this piece. And I've read through some of the lyrics here, and as usual, it's intense, y'all. He is going right after it. So I'm ready to get after it as well. Let's dive into Deadhead from Devin Townsend live at the Royal Albert Hall in 2015. We ready? All right, here we go. Suspended five chord, back up to six, flat six, and a minor key, down to five, four. Just, the wall of sound just surrounds you. Hang on a second, What did he say? I'm going back a little bit. It's about love. Love is a bitch. Okay, so that's one hint.
Right.
Back to the minor. C minor. E flat major. Relative minor and relative major oscillating back and forth between themselves. Okay. That E flat chord goes up by a step to F, then back down. It's like, what's up, people? Are you with me? Slow moving and all enveloping, right? It's amazing. Still going back and forth between C and E flat. Relationship between the major and the minor. Just oscillating back and forth. You are a sun goddess, will you save me? Save me from what? B flat. Now the rain it comes, the rain it blurs the gray line, the gray line, the greyhound home. So he's murky here, he's in the gray. You are thinks you're vicious. Hurt me, I can take it. That's the F major chord. Down to E flat. He's got a voice that can fill a space, can he? It works with this wall of sound type of music so well. Over that C minor. Just big sound. Will you save me? Boy, if that's not a petition for help, I don't know what is. That strikes me right here. Because it's all in the heat of the moment. It's all in the pain. And he's playing major chords. That's the thing. F major down to E flat. Give in to the pain. I remember when I would first be doing these reactions, and I'd hear a vocal like that, and I'd be like, no, he's hurting his voice. He's not singing correctly. Screw that. I have moved on from that. That's unbelievable, y'all, because I have learned that it's about the color of the sound and the intensity with how those the vocal cords are just rubbing against each other. It causes that sound to have that color to it, that intensity, that immediacy to it. and it's effective in this style of music, for sure. Wow. I can't wait to hear it again. I need to watch that entire live concert. I'm sure the video's out there somewhere. Because I remember very much enjoying the pieces that we heard, Funeral Bastard and the Death of Music, back in January. So, wow, let's do it. Devin has said, as far as what the song is about, what its overall meaning is, it's up for interpretation a bit. He has said that the title of this song was derived or inspired from a song of the same name by a band called Godflesh. I have not gone and listened to the Godflesh song of same name, but I did pull the lyrics to it. And in their song, they say, "Dying ocean, dead head, watching the figures march without soul." Without your sky, I'm kind of skipping through, watching all the figures. Meaning, or they are referring in their song, I think, to a person or a group of people as dead heads. Meaning that they've lost their soul. They're just going through the motions of life, observing more than living life to its fullest, right? In Devin's tune, although he said, I think twice, that love is a bitch, I think that multiple meanings can be derived from this based on our point of view. For sure, it is calling on the power of a relationship to free him, free us from what is afflicting us. It could be sexual. It could be an attempt to save or rekindle a relationship. It could be a relationship with drugs. It could be a relationship with yourself, and you're just simply seeking enlightenment. It could be spiritual. It could be a prayer, a petition for peace and clarity, whatever. And however we take this, I think it's clear that it comes from a point of view of real intense need I don't know if y'all can hear that. Right in the middle of this, my brain got thrown off track because there is a lawnmower outside, right outside our window. Oh, what was I saying? However we take this, y'all, I think that it comes from this point of view of need of a real passion and a desire to improve or satisfy that need. And he's willing to go through pain to achieve it. In the lyrics, it's all in the pain, so give in to the heat of the moment, give in to the pain. Dang, y'all. Whatever the circumstance or however we think about it, I think he truly is reaching out for help. And he's ready to accept it and become better, to become more fulfilled, more content, more alive, right? To not be a deadhead anymore. Maybe in the end, the message is simply not to avoid or hide from our feelings too much, from our observations too much, to live in them, to express them, even if it's painful. Because, you know, in my experience, denying these intense feelings and trying to suppress them only makes things worse. And you become dead a little bit inside. And so I've kind of gone all around this, but the power of this music it gives a space similar to what I've found in the music of Pink Floyd, with these expansive sections that just allow us to live in that emotion, to live in that sound. And there's multiple connotations that can spring from it, because life is complicated and love is shared. We all understand that. And sometimes love is a bitch, like Devin said. But love can also save us as well. And sometimes the pain of love can help. We can go, we can take it, he says. He says, hurt me, I can take it. And this other section, because it's all in the heat of the moment, it's all in the pain, sonar, again, we're pinging for that response. He said, got no wings, gossamer wings. Gossamer is something that is really light, really delicate, right? So the more I think about it, the more it's kind of moving some layers around for me a bit. So maybe I should stop recording this and go back and listen to the whole thing again on my own time. Thanks, y'all, for hanging out with me. This is a wonderful thing. I need to get back to more Devin's music more often here on the channel. He always makes me really think and always provides me with a really profound musical experience, for sure. Whew, it's been a fun one today. Thanks, y'all. We'll see you next time on another edition of The Daily Dog.